Hi, everyone. I'm absolutely thrilled that you're here today. I'll tell you a little bit about the work. So much of my work surrounds this idea that we're in a participatory world where you see things and they see you equally back. It's so much about, you know, as a dancer, I know you know this, your five senses, you know, being very present in your body and really listening and feeling and seeing the whole world around us, the natural world. I take a lot of inspiration from different patterns I see out in nature. And so much of the work to me is inspired by the music that I hear out in the natural world. And so I use a lot of repetition and building up an accumulation of pattern and color to really kind of, you know, my understanding of my body in the world. It's a sort of invitation to really slow down and to really use your body and the five senses to experience the natural world. I like to create installations like this where you are immersed with the work, and that it also very directly enjoy, you know, the relationship of your body to the work. So with this, I purposely wanted you to sort of look down and be amongst and around. It's called A Place in the Sun, and it's in response to, you know, the heating of our planet, really, and the kind of, I live in Sacramento, and it's still hot there, and it's the end of October, and every year the heat just lingers longer and longer. So so much of my work is in response to this, the growing climate crisis, and just trying to bring more awareness. I know so many young people, I don't have to say this to you guys because it's part of your world. So today, you know, I made a nice list of prompts inspired, you know, like things that I thought might be inspiring to think about while you're dancing. You know, I love jazz and free jazz. So if you can kind of, you know, just, you know, be present, be in your body, you know, think about, you know, how the natural world moves. And then also, you know, these guys, they're like my children. They've been up here for like 2 months, you know, like they're frizzed out, and, you know, like staying loose. And just really like they're moving, you know, so yeah, move like them. Thank you so much. Any questions or?
Yeah, any questions or kind of thoughts or curiosities about Mercy's work that you'd like to know more?
What was kind of like the building process of each of these, like, you know, pieces? Because I know
yeah.
That you have similar, like, kind of stylistic.
Yeah, I definitely work a lot with puzzle pieces. I like sort of make puzzle pieces, and then I work very improvisationally. Like, it's very in collaboration always with the materials. I like to invite a lot of chance, or let them tell me what they want to be also. So I make the little puzzle pieces, and you can kind of see where the seams are, and then I sew them together. So there's a lot of repetition and building up of rhythms. If you look closely, I do a lot of dashing. So much of it is, I want you to see the evidence of the artist's hand, you know, like all over the whole thing. A real presence is what I'm looking for, which is why I love them out here in the wind, because they start to move and they feel, you know, kind of uncanny or in a state of a aliveness, or at least presence. And I wanted these ones to look a little figurative. So they are, in my mind, they're little people, kind of. They're little figures, but also a little bit embracing a sort of language, you know, the way we characterize the written symbols we use to communicate. So kind of a nice marriage between those two.
And what about logistically speaking, as they interact with them, can they touch them, or should they be a little further away?
You can touch them, definitely. They're not breakable. I would be careful of tripping. I don't want you to fall on the concrete, so just maybe don't. But they've been out here 2 months. They're super tough. They'll take. Yeah, you can touch them or play with her hair. It was quite a feat. Yeah, thank you for that question because it was difficult. The wind is super mild right now, but we planned for the windiest day. They're actually Pellegrino bottles underneath, filled with water, and then I went and bought little BB pellets. So we were up here for a little while and we'd watch. It was a windy day when we installed and we just watched which ones fell over and I just added more BB pellets to those. Yeah, it was fun. And they stay up now, and they also have like these kind of paint sticks, right, that are taped around the Pellegrino bottles, and they're slid down into these cracks. So it's like extra reinforcement. One falls over here and there, Nell said, but they've been pretty good. And the blue one, the mother, that's the one I consider the mother. Usually when I make an installation, there's always like one mother piece, like to watch out for everyone, and that's the mother. And she's staying up. Yeah. Any other questions?
Were the two art pieces downstairs, I'm guessing yours too?
Yeah. I wouldn't, no, in my head they're not the mother. No, there's no mothers there. Like more big installations, this one I felt needed a mother because they are going to be out here in the night, in the wind and the rain, and, you know, just some nurturing here and there.
I'm thinking about motherhood.
Right. I really pushed them out. I worked really hard. Thank you for that question. I made like 1.5 a day, like for about a month. There's like 28 of them. Yeah, I worked so hard. And then the arches, I can make one in about 2 days, but that was really, really working hard. This summer, it was like July and August. So 2 months, I kind of made the whole thing. Yeah, it's Yupo paper, which is a kind of watercolor paper. It's plastic, and then it's painted with acrylic. And then I just use color pencils and then just various types of fiber and yarn, lots of linen yarn, because it's very strong. And then, you know, upcycled, I'll get yarn from thrift stores and stuff. So that's basically, yeah. Yupo paper, it's a kind of plastic. So it has a rigidity and it has structure and I'm able to sew it without it falling apart. These are all there's hand sewing and machine sewing. So yeah, that's how it, plastic. Did you ask, is jazz in all the pieces?
Like, is jazz an influence?
Oh, definitely. My partner who's here today is a jazz scholar, so I'm very influenced by so much of the music that he plays. And I really, so many things I love about jazz, but one of my favorite things is that it's so easy to, jazz like lets you be there too. It doesn't tell you what to think and, for me, so much jazz is about a lot of things, but I also think it has a real connection to the natural world and so much of this kind of relationship between humans and the natural world. They're literally, you know, blowing through instruments, the breath, you know, through a reed that vibrates. So there's so much about jazz that I love it. Yeah, it definitely is an influence and in everything.
Thank you. Thank you.